In this video, we're going to talk about the washer method of finding the volume of the solid by revolving it around about the line y is equal to 2. Okay, and notice that we use the same boundaries as in the previous problem. So let's draw the xy plane again, and let's draw those boundaries again. So we have the y-axis constraint, we have the y is equal to 1 constraint. Okay, and we're stopping here because this curve is 0 at x is equal to 0, and then it's 1 at x is equal to 2, right? Because 2 squared is 4, 4 divided by 4 is 1, so it's right here. So this curve rises like this. Okay, so the region of interest is going to be this part here. Okay, so now we can, okay, so but the only difference between this example and the last one is that we're going to revolve this region about the line y is equal to 2. Okay, so now this tells you that it's parallel to the x-axis, the axis of revolution. So that means that we're integrating with respect to x. With respect to x from x is equal to 0 to x is equal to 2. Right, because these are the x values that bound this region. Okay, so now, as you can tell, this is a washer method, meaning that you will have a hole, you will have the outer radius and an inner radius. Okay, so notice that the inner radius is going to be the distance from this line y is equal to 2 to the curve y is equal to 1 4 x squared. So I'm just going to say the outer radius distance from the line y is equal to 2 to the curve y is equal to 1 4 x squared. Okay, so this is the RO. Okay, now the inner radius is going to be this part, right? The part that you will need to subtract from the outer radius. Okay, so the inner radius is going to be distance from the line y is equal to 2 to the line y is equal to 1. Right, and you know the volume of this solid that you're going to generate will be equal to pi r squared h. Okay, so you will need to use the integral twice and use in each integral the outer radius and the inner radius in the formula. And as you know, the height in the integral will be dx, right? And the radius in each case. So did we determine what the inner radius, the outer radius is? The outer radius is going to be, well, let me just write it here. So the outer radius is going to be the distance from the line y is equal to 2 to the curve, right? So how are we going to measure that distance? We're going to measure it as 2 minus, right? We're going to subtract this part here, right? We're going to subtract this distance from the x-axis to the curve from 2, right? So 2 minus 1 4 x squared. Okay, now the inner radius is going to be easy, right? It's the distance from y is equal to 2 to y is equal to 1, so it's going to be 2 minus 1 is equal to 1, right? So now the volume of the solid generated by revolving it around about the line y is equal to 2 is going to be from 0 to 2, as we discussed, the limits of integration for the x with respect to x. So it's going to be pi pi ro squared dx. Well, I'm just going to use it as a subscript before, but I'm going to do 2 minus 1 4 x squared squared dx. And I'm going to note to you that this is the RO, okay, the outer radius, minus the same integral from 0 to 2, pi 1 squared dx, right? And this is the inner radius, okay, subtracting the inner radius from the outer radius. Okay, so then we're going to have, we can combine this integral, actually, from 0 to 2. We're going to take the pi out, and we're going to do 2 minus 1 4 x squared squared minus 1 dx. Okay, so now let's simplify this. So we're going to have from 0 to 2, 4 minus 1 half minus 1 half, that's going to give you minus x squared. I'm just doing the FOIL method, the second and third steps in my head. Plus 1 16 x to the fourth minus 1 dx. And that's going to give me from 0 to 2. I'm just going to take care of, start from the higher powers and go to the lower ones, descend, minus x squared plus 3 dx. So now let's take the antiderivative. We're going to keep the pi. So we're going to have 1 16 multiplied by 1 fifth, right, x to the fifth, from 0 to 2, minus 1 third x to the third from 0 to 2, plus 3 x from 0 to 2. So that's going to give me pi multiplied by 1 80th times 32 minus 83, right, plus 6. So let's see what that gives you. Pi multiplied by 32 over 80 is the same thing as 16 over 40, 8 over 20, 4 over 10, 2 over 5. So 2 over 5 minus 83 plus 6. So let's talk about the greatest common factor. The greatest common factor will be 15, I believe. Yeah, so we'll have 6 minus 40 plus, what's 15 times 6? That's 80, I believe, right? Minus 8, plus 80 over 15. So I'm gonna put the result on the top here. Sorry, running out of space. So that's 40 plus 6. Wait, did I get it right? Let's try it again. 15 times 6. 15 times 3 is 40. Oh, oops. It's 90. Oops. Yeah. So it should be 90 over 15. So I'm going to put the result on the top. And it's going to get 50 plus 6 is 56, right? So 56 pi over 15. So that's your resulting volume of the solid generated by revolving the given region with the given boundaries. Okay, so I hope that you found this video useful. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video.